in the real estate section of the Times probably about a year ago now, and you know, the title was "Psst, Have You Heard About Bushwick?" And it's so clear and so shameless, really, who the audience is. It's like Bushwick has never been discovered. There's not already 100,000, you know, low-income Latino families living there. They're interested in the kid who gets priced out of Williamsburg.
And that's basically what's happening in the city, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah, people. I'm so impressed that every night there's a meeting, right?
Yeah.
And how many people come to these meetings?
It depends, but almost always more than 30 and often more than 60.
So incredible.
Parents are gathering on Monday nights, and while they're gathering, you know, there's 25 people in an English class, and the Youth Power Project is publishing their newspaper, doing their theater group, having an organizing committee meeting. So every night the place is buzzing with vitality. And I think that the message or the lesson is not that we're so great at our jobs. The lesson is that given an opportunity to participate in the civic life of this city, folks will do it if you treat them with respect. You understand that they're not kind of pieces to be manipulated and moved around, but you say, what should we do? You make the decisions. People, what we've found is people have exceeded our expectations almost every time.
Do you, you also support legislation, don't you?
Absolutely.
You lobby? So are you a nonprofit that people can contribute to?
Absolutely.
And you have a website?
We have a website, which is www.maketheroad.org, and it's possible to make donations straight from the website.
But you sponsor legislation. And how much legislation do you have now that you're interested in?
Well, we are working on a couple major legislative initiatives. We've had some success winning legislative initiatives in the past. The current bill that I think we're most committed to is something called the Safe Housing Act. That both the speaker and the mayor have announced that they support. So I think we're in good shape. Right. But essentially what it does is it creates a new program that would guarantee that the worst apartments in New York City get repaired either by the owner, and if the owner is MIA, by HPD relatively quickly. So we're talking about 2,000 plus apartments every year with HPD stepping in and doing kind of major repairs, so that instead of just putting new drywall over in a leaking ceiling, we're talking about them actually fixing the leak and making the major systemic repairs that often don't.
Do you have what is the Rent Stabilization Board? Where are they?
They're on board, actually. They announced their support. And
good.
I think it's a testament, really, to the speaker's kind of work to bring everyone on board. And she put in some things that they've been wanting about, you know, self-certification that repairs are made. But she brought it together, and HPD had been really resistant
eventually
came
helpful.
Around. Yeah.
So are there other areas that have similar organizations, or are they broader?
There are many organizations around the city. They tend to be, I think what's unique about Make the Road is that we're multi-generational, we're multi-issue, and even though most of our members are immigrants from Latin America, we've got a bunch of members who are Puerto Rican or African American, and so we're not organized ethnically. So I think those are the things that are unusual. There are many organizations who are working in just one community. There are many folks who do adult education.
Yeah.
There are many youth organizations, and then there are many kind of ethnically organized communities, but not kind of in the same way.
And you work with other organizations.
We work really closely.
The organized clergy.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're very helpful, aren't they?
Enormously helpful, and we've got pretty progressive clergy in our community, so we work a lot on our campaign to increase wages and improve working conditions of the neighborhood. Local pastors have been enormously supportive. We're actually in the process of organizing a protest where the congregants of multiple churches will convene on this associated supermarket that owes their workers close to $2 million in back
wages.
I
feel sorry for Associated Food Market because they don't know what's going to happen to them, right?
Yeah. I think that's right, but they're not worthy of your sorrow.
All right. Where are you physically located?
We are located right
near. Do you have a building?
We do. We don't own it. We rent, actually, essentially three storefronts and the back of a local credit union that are all adjoining. So we have our central office, and then two doors down, we kind of have rented the back of the Brooklyn Cooperative Credit Union. And we're on Grove Street between Myrtle and Knickerbocker Avenues.
That's great. And your board, it consists of Members.
Our members elect our board of directors. Right. And so each organizing committee, the youth, the parents, the workers, the folks who are doing housing organizing, and then our civil rights group, and we have a lesbian and gay project also, they each get to elect a board member. That those folks constitute the entire executive committee of our board and are the majority of our board. They periodically will invite someone. We're trying to do a capital campaign, so they invited an architect to join the board. So we have a couple other folks who are kind of fellow travelers who get invited onto the board by the members who are elected.
Do you see that there's a different feeling in the neighborhood of a buoyant kind of optimistic feeling?
I think there is definitely there's this vibrancy that wasn't there when we got there, yeah. And it's much safer. All of the new immigration, I think, has really revitalized the economy of the neighborhood and also just the energy. Right. Folks are feeling positive. Tons of kids. The parks are full. So it's great.
You don't have many parks.
This is a problem. We have fewer parks than any other neighborhood in all of New York City except for East Flatbush. And it's a real concern because the housing is overcrowded. Often the apartments are poorly maintained, so folks need a place to go and kids need a place to play. And so that's something that we are very serious about. The one thing that I would say is there is an impending sense of anxiety over the gentrification mm-hmm. of the neighborhood, the rising prices, particularly the rising rents. So I think that's something that kind of coexists with the optimism and the vibrancy.
It's such a conflict in the city, isn't it? Do most of your people have jobs?
Many of our people, probably half, and then a bunch of people are either unable to work because they're primary caretakers or because they
are receiving disabilities. Are there a lot of single parent families?
Yeah, tons of single family parent.
Do you have childcare?
We do have childcare. Every single meeting, we have childcare. We have food. So we think it's important for those folks, particularly in many ways, not because they're powerful, but because they're alienated and isolated, to have a place to come together and talk about what's going on in their lives.
Have you ever regretted that you didn't go to work in a law firm or to work with a hedge fund?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I think it's really been an honor to be part of Make the Road by Walking and to meet all the amazing, courageous people who are, much more courageous, talking about your child who has been poisoned by lead-based paint. Yeah. These are really heroic folks, and so it's been an honor
to
be
there. And people to come, to leave a country and to come here.
Absolutely.
It's the pioneering spirit that they must, I'm so glad that you've been able to connect to them. And I wish we had more people like you in the world, because I know the world would be a better place. Thank you very much for
coming.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you. If there are any people you'd like to hear and topics you'd like us to explore, please let me know. You can write to me at CUNY TV, 365 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York, 10016, or you can go to the website at cuny.tv and click on Contact Us. I look forward to hearing from you.